A pain threshold is the point at which a subject begins to experience pain from an outward stimulus. For example, a clamp being tightened around your wrist would not immediately hurt. It would start with discomfort, and then the fight-or-flight response would kick in as you begin to feel constricted. Finally, you would experience pain after reaching the pain threshold pressure. Your pain threshold is likely different from every other person, just as it is for your pain threshold temperature, when heat or cold begins to register in your subjective mind as painful. So, if every person's pain threshold is different, does that arise from psychological, physical, or genetic factors? That's something the researchers have been trying to determine for many years. First of all, there are two components of pain tolerance. First is the pain receptors in our skin that send the signal to the brain, while the second is the brain's perception of the pain. This determines how much attention is given to the pain. Multiple factors determine the tolerance of each individual, including sex, age, neonatal injury, and psychological factors. In their efforts to quantify pain, researchers at the University of Cornell attempted to quantify pain tolerance through a measurement of pain sensitivity called dolorimetry. However, the unit of measurement never really caught on in the scientific community, and while there has been a lot of talk concerning humans' ultimate threshold of pain, there is no universal or objective scale. This uncertainty stymies scientists, but it's unavoidable. As mentioned above, physical, psychological, and genetic factors all play a role in the subjective perception of pain for human beings, making precise quantification and comparison nearly impossible. As a child, imagine that you were protected from every possible danger by your parents. If you have never experienced the pain of a broken bone or a scraped knee, your pain threshold would likely be quite low. Another child who spent years spraining their ankles and being in and out of casts would develop a higher tolerance for pain. Psychologically, some prefer to bear their pain in silence and stoicism, while others resort to complaining, crying, and pill-popping as their response to pain. Some cultures see the admission of pain as a sign of weakness, so they have literally been conditioned in a mind-over-matter attitude by their family or society. This is another aspect to the psychological nature of pain. If we can focus solely on pleasant or pleasure-inducing thoughts, we can legitimately dull our sensitivity to pain. Clearly, there are many factors to consider in the measurement of pain, but there is no ultimate threshold for pain in human beings. A sudden spike in pain can also lead to a temporary interruption in the functioning of the autonomous nervous system. The ANS is responsible for controlling your heart rate and blood pressure. A pain-induced interruption can lead to a drop in your heart rate and blood pressure, which affects the blood supply to the brain and can even result in fainting. The amount of pain that would cause fainting depends on each person's unique pain tolerance. While you may be curious about your own pain tolerance, we do not recommend trying to find that threshold.